cane. Just a little play around on this for a couple of hours while this disaster is still going. And waiting for October when the monsters and all the events come out. That will be fun. Haven't played this for a few days. Probably due to the fact that I've completed the challenges and the thing was broken and yada yada yada. And something's changed. From
death is not mercurial. It's patient. Unlike life.
From pre-Rampart days, this thing has changed a lot.
Time to dig up some gold.
I am prepared for the fight.
That is good. Good for you.
This is your champion.
We're all having a good time, especially me.
Yeah. Apparently, we're getting some.
I suggest this landing location. I feel most alive when rapidly approaching my death.
Are you finished? We're gonna get some Loba trackers and a Loba skin for free in the Monsters event. I'm kind of excited about that. Appears this is our stop. Oh gosh. I assume that I need to get a weapon of some kind. I picked up two wings. So far.
Round three. Victory is within reach.
Oh hell, I haven't got much ammunition, have I? Sounds good to me, thank you. What else do we have around here that I haven't picked up? This.
Taking a moment to recharge my shields.
Doesn't appear to be much of anything else.
One more minute.
Recharging my shields.
What's this thing? Never seen that before.
We have 45 seconds, and the next ring right there. Don't leave anything good behind.
Here we come. robot. I really need to get a better weapon.
We've got 10 seconds. I hate to say it, but looting time's over.
Where is the ring? Move. Nowhere important.
To those who need it, there is an extended barrel stabilizer here. Level 3.
I got the treasure pack.
Pointless.
I need a treasure pack. I don't need that either. I'm not too sure if we want to do this. And by do this, I mean put down the shot.
Charge rifle here.
Put the shot. Put the shot. Should I put the shot down?
Should
I put the shot down? Should I put the shot down? The shot's going to create a lot of interest. Get rid of that thing. Alright, I'm still here. Don't know where they are, they've gone for a walk. Aha, I'll take that. Even though the single shot's pretty decent. Nothing I want. Where have they gone to? Actually, this is pretty decent. But now I've got to weigh things out a bit. I'm going to jump up to the roof. Whoa! Got on up here, a bit of stuff here and there. Bit of this, bit of that. And weighed all of that on there. They're over there somewhere.
Evo shield here, level 2.
Oh yes, please. I'll take that one.
Deeps.
Take that too. Oh, look at this.
Optics here.
I can't carry anything.
Sniper.
Else. That. Go back and grab this. Where are they? In there. I'm kind of...
Sniper stock here.
Oh,
level 3.
Oh, really? I probably...
I suggest we do some research in this area.
I'll take that.
Do you want me to ult in here? I can ult inside. Like... what you got here?
Welcome to the shop. I've got just the thing for you.
Path is closed.
That's what I want.
I struck the cargo pod.
Did you? That's nice. Now, what do I want? I want to get over here real quick because I can hear something coming. And I need a bag. Ah, there's no bag. Oh, yes, I have got a bag. What else can I use? That would be of interest to me. And bring like this. Woo! That will do. There's one
Don't
thing.
Don't mind if I do.
Oh. Take that. And. What else have I got? I don't need this. Take some of that.
The next ring is not close.
Oh, what's that? Look at that. Good to me. And I've got one of those. I've got one of these. That's nice.
Replicator on high.
Don't need that at all. I guess we're just going to hang out here for a while. Don't hear anyone. I've got enough medkit stuff.
Remember who hooked you up. I've got your back.
Bang. Boom.
This way.
New kill leader appointed. We have a new kill leader.
I
can't wait to meet them.
Well, I'm not sure if we're going to because we don't seem to be meeting anyone. What's this gold thing over here?
Come on, we've got 45 seconds and a long way to go.
Okay. I'm not sure if I knew that existed.
Only 30 seconds remain. The ring moves.
Yes. I'm gonna catch up, okay? Oh, how far have we got to go? Quite a bit. Is, and yet we're far from it. Not sure what's going to happen right here.
The ring is moving, Fly fighters. No one is inside. Scanning for the next ring. Use your map to guide you.
I suggest we do some research in this area.
There's someone over there.
Those care packages likely shift the Delta in our favor.
How many squads left? 7. Bloody hell. I'm gonna sneak up around the outside here.
Gas trap deployed.
Don't see anything. That almost made me shit myself.
We're already inside the next ring.
Gas trap deployed.
Enemy over there. Don't let them see you.
Replicator being delivered.
Beautiful. We have a replicator coming in. There's someone here.
Incoming
shields.
Damn it, you can't ever use that thing, it's just hopeless. I don't know, we went back into the building, I don't know. Whatever. Oh, I got a little hat. Don't need any of this stuff anymore. I don't know, I haven't even really been excited about trying to do this either. Deal 25,000 damage, get 100. Yeah.
Back to King's Canyon. How nostalgic.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting. Look at the charms. Yeah. What do you do? Don't need that on there at all. Look at the store, shall we? Recoil control. What the hell is that? Yeah, show. Oh, sorry. What's the other one? No. Oh, damn it. I've lost all my stuff. I moved the folder and it all has disappeared from OBS. I'll have to remap it in the weekend.
Don't settle. I'm not made that way.
All right, I'm gonna be honest. I'm afraid. I'm really afraid. I'm just kidding. Nothing scares me.
We have no choice but to win.
Whoa! Wow, this is a pretty hardcore bunch of people. Oh, they've completed all the challenges.
I'm the jump master.
No, you're falling for me already. No.
It's time. I'm the jump master.
I like that spot, and that spot, and this spot.
Here we go. Ready up. Let's do this.
Okay. That sounds like a reasonable request. Oh, what the hell? Are we going in here already? Apparently so. Ooh, ah, E, I don't need that. Let's go. I might take these. Wait, this is fun. Oh my god, is there somebody out there? Spike, are you kidding me?
I think there's a trapper out here.
Beginning ring countdown.
We're already in the next ring.
Where's the other one?
Get out there and bamboozle.
Okay. What are we shooting at? Monster?
This place has seen activity.
Go out and bamboozle them.
Firing. Contact with hostile. Reloading.
I'll take. Sorry about that, everyone. What are we listening to here? Not sure we should be listening to music. Playing this.
Attention.
That's some champion, huh?
Yeah. Whoa, somebody actually opened these for me.
Well, aren't you impressive? I might have to add you to my collection.
We're down to 50% left. That's a pretty easy math. L-Star here.
Reloading.
Only three of them. Not doing too well. What was I looking at? I was looking at the store, eh? We got tied and tested and air show. I mean, that's pretty cool, but you got to get tied and tested. No, you don't want over.
What are you waiting for? Let's do this.
Okay, well, that's nice. I was going to give you over. I should have taken lifeline or something else.
This fight will result in death for the weak. So be it.
Introducing your champion.
We've got the champion. Let's just go and fire my smoke everywhere.
This landing area will prove beneficial.
I fight to be free of your acceptance.
Yes,
I will not
apologize
for simply expediting the inevitable. I will not apologize for simply expediting the inevitable. I will not apologize for simply. My hypothesis is correct. I am unstoppable.
I love this part!
Success.
Oh dear.
Enemy in sight.
Holy shit. We landed right on top of an enemy. I don't particularly want to do that.
Longbow here.
We're already in the ring.
What? Longbow? There's something. Give me something.
Eva 8 here.
Thanks.
Let's get down there. Oh, good. That's good. Apparently not.
Longbow here. Spotted one. Close. Begins.
New kill leader. Call him.
Trap is set. Data soon to follow. Gas trap deployed. Independent variable added. Enemy spotted. Close. Spotted one.
Energy ammo here. Havoc rifle here.
Tossing thermite. Throwing thermite.
Thank you.
area has been disturbed.
So what do we want to do? This guy's dead. You realize that? Who is this? Oh, it's our mate. He just fell over and died. Don't know where my friend
find
is.
Ourselves inside the next ring. How serendipitous. I have a subject in view. Far off.
Oh yeah, I forgot. I forgot who I was playing.
Reloading.
Oh shit, man.
Killed one myself. Those care packages likely shift the Delta in our favor. Reloading. Target spotted. An independent variable. Spotted a subject. My vision is clear. Target spotted. There. I suspect we will find something here.
Reloading.
Taking fire. The trap is set. Data soon to follow. I still see everything.
Give me a sec. Recharging shield.
Enemy spotted.
Yeah, I saw.
Shields Roger. Are recharging.
I got a shotgun and a piece of garbage free shooter, pea shooter.
Oh,
that's cool.
Truant?
Tornado. That coming. Interesting how you can do that, eh? Oh, he's a champion too, I forgot about that. If we can get some kind of good gaming happening.
In the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Mike A asks us, what is the difference between bees, wasps, and hornets?
Don't know.
There are many similarities and differences between our little wing-whipping friends. For starters, they can all sting you. That said, you may derive some solace in the fact that when certain of them sting humans, they die. Although it's not true that they do that when they sting other animals. The barbs, stingers on honeybees particularly, end up getting lodged in our soft flesh, ripping out their backsides when they try and get away after stinging. When they sting most other animals, that simply doesn't happen. Further.
That's not cool.
If you want to win.
My squad is my family.
Introducing your champion.
Well, now we start to see these badges coming up.
Trust me, we want to land over here. Yeah. Let's go!
Okay. Yeah, I think they're coming. Is there anything in here that actually matches the ammunition that's in here?
This time I'm down.
Holy shit, how many people are there? Could we? Of course, this is the problem with the game right now. Because the last two games, we had two players.
Wasps and hornets all proliferate in warm weather, their hives growing in the spring and the early summer. By late summer, food becomes scarce, and that's when they, especially wasps and hornets, start finding their way to human food and your picnic. While the colors are all pretty similar, brown and black, yellow, and maybe some white on bees, wasps, and hornets, the markings, they do differ. This is where the insects, we all tend to lump into the same category, flying, stinging, and scary, begin to show their differences. Let's start with a humble bee. Bees are fairy pollen collectors who rarely ever have any need to interact with humans. As the expression, as busy as a bee insinuates, worker bees, usually the only type of bee that most people see, spend their lives going to and from the hive, acquiring nectar and pollen on their bodies during their trips. They play an integral part in the pollination of various plants, and some of them they provide us with tasty honey. They feed the acquired nectar to their young, developing the new generation of bees. They also protect the queen bee, allowing her to lay eggs. There are over 25,000 known bee species, but the two most common types of bees are honeybees and bumblebees. Both produce wax, but, and I know this is going to come as a shock, only the honeybee produces honey. Another big difference between the two is that the bumblebee is nearly double the size of the honeybee. Bumblebees are fat, at least in bee terms, and they're hairy. Their size, relative to their wingspan, gives rise to the myth that science can't explain how they're able to fly. Honeybees are more sleek. They both are yellow with black stripes, although the bumblebee often has a red, orange, or white tail. Additionally, honeybees live in large colonies, topping out...
We'll come back to that later.
Master, don't worry, I'll take care of you. Let's land here. Eyes on the prize.
Yes.
I just don't like the responsiveness of landing and opening one of these things. It's just pathetic.
Next ring is distant.
I've got nothing. How lucky am I?
Attention, first blood.
First blood. Well, you can't solve the eternal mysteries of the universe without breaking a few eggs.
I can hear a lot of people having a bit of a powwow.
I see someone over there.
We want to run over there, do we? Oh, shall I grenade out there? How are we supposed to smartly take this on? Sure what goes through people's minds. Yeah.
25,000 bees. Well, bumblebees tend to build their nests underground, although their nests have also been found in walls, and they're often found in tunnels constructed by other animals. Their colonies are much smaller than bumblebees, only numbering into the hundreds. Wasps, unlike bees, are aggressive and predators. There are over 30,000 species of wasps, and they are distinguishable from bees by their pointed lower abdomens and narrow waist. They also have little to no hair on their bodies, as opposed to bees, and they don't play much of a role in the pollination of plants. Their legs are shiny, slender, and shaped like cylinders. All wasps hunt for food, and they build nests for shelter. What exactly they prey on and how they build their nests depends on the type of wasp. There are two general types of wasps, social and solitary. Social wasps build colonies and start from scratch every spring, never nesting in the same spot twice. They design their home out of chewed up wood fibers and their own saliva. The nests may hold up to 5,000 wasps and are typically found in protected spaces like attics, inside of walls, or under decks. Social wasps eat many different types of things. They are omnivorous, including fruits, plants, human food, and other insects. Solitary wasps do not form colonies and live underground in tubular mud nests. There's no caste system, as in the queen cares for its own young. The queen seeks out prey, flies, bee larvae, cicadas. There's actually a species of wasp known as cicada killers, and they paralyze them with their sting. They take the still-living insect back to the nest and feed it to their larva. It's during the late summer that wasps begin to get aggressive. This is due to...
Okay. Who's coming with us? Oh dear. Maybe we should. I can hear somebody. Shh, just be quiet.
Long way to the next ring. Lots of ground means lots of treasure.
Yes, I can hear someone.
Throwing an arc star.
I don't actually have a weapon.
Shields
are eliminated.
enemy here, fellas.
Got a long way to recharging my shield.
Compose myself. I'm recharging my shield.
I need some more ammunition.
Juice in me shields.
45 seconds. Let's get to the next ring.
I need shields.
Everybody needs something. Oh shit, there's three people up there. Because we get wasted by Jesus stuff.
Making contact with enemy.
The fact that the worker wasp's job is done for the year and they're literally waiting to die. After taking care of the queen and feeding the new generation of worker wasps, the old ones are useless. They become disorientated and begin to venture away from the nest in search of food. Sweet. As absurd as this sounds, these wasps have nothing left to live for besides satisfying their sweet tooth, so they become aggressive, bold, and persistent. They'll land on a human hand that's holding an ice cream cone, they'll dive into a can of soda, they'll munch on a half-eaten apple. In fact, in September of 2013, the British Red Cross warned citizens that wasps were getting drunk on fermented fruit and were going out in search of more. Joe Mulligan of the Red Cross said to the British newspaper The Independent in 2013, "It's hilarious that now worker wasps have finished their life's work. All they are now doing is feasting on fermented fruit and getting drunk." All that being said, wasps are not just pests, but they benefit humanity in some way. They prey on other pest insects and have actually been used by the agricultural industry as an effective means to control crop pests, resulting in much more environmentally friendly ways to do this over many pesticides. Hornets are actually a species of wasp. Hornets differ from other wasps in that their stings are more venomous. They also tend to attack for food as a colony, and their nests are aerial as opposed to many wasp species. The giant Asian hornet, native to parts of Russia, China, Vietnam, and the mountains of Japan, can grow to about 2 inches long with a wingspan of about 4 to 5 inches. It is the world's largest and most venomous wasp. It is colloquially known as the yak killer due to the venom's ability to dissolve the tissue of even the largest of mammals. Because the honeybee is, on an individual level, incapable of harming the giant Asian hornet, and just a handful of giant Asian hornets are capable of decimating an entire hive of honeybees, the Japanese honeybee has come up with an alternate strategy to stopping the mass destruction of their populace by the hornets. When a giant Asian hornet is detected, first the honeybee will emit a pheromone that the hornet can pick up, and it basically says, "I see you." The scouting hornet might then leave. If not, and the hornet continues towards the hive, the honeybees will ball the hornet, essentially surrounding it completely with as many bees as possible. They will.
Good grief. I wonder if this guy is alive.
I'm the job master.
No, they're not.
Don't worry, I'll take it. I like this. Eyes on the prize.
He's not detected, and he is not detected. Picking up rubbish I don't need, like this, so hold on to that. What do we got in here? Not much of anything good by the looks of it. Yes, I got. So can I swap these over?
I look forward to you all getting acquainted.
Draw a thing like it.
Shops open for VIPs only.
I would like.
Thanks.
Where is
Knockdown shield here. Level 4.
Well, I have to get it first.
Nice choice. You've got good taste.
I certainly would probably prefer this. And probably some of this.
My ultimate is ready. The hunt begins.
I'll take the knockdown shield. I stole everything.
I need shields.
You need shields. There's probably shields out here.
Shield cell here. Ooh, care package on the way. I like the sound of that.
Thanks.
Backpack here. Level 2.
Medkit here.
What have I actually got?
I could use that.
A lot of stuff. Let me just nip down here and grab this Phoenix kit. Maybe one of those. No, can't get down. Can't get anything there.
Thank you.
Does it need shield batteries and stuff? I don't know.
here. Taking a moment to recharge my shields. I need shields. Ultimate accelerant here.
Anyone up for some shopping? Nice choice. You got good taste.
Old father, give me sight.
What do I need?
Throwing jump pad.
My favorite kind of loot. The kind that's all mine.
Okay, see someone out there. Target over there.
Really? Here I see.
Marking our surroundings. Contact with target. Hostile spotted.
Here I come. How far out are they though? Quite far out. Do we want to
just
go?
Just spotted someone out there. Watch your kneecap. I'll blow up this hold.
It's so lagging.
Yeah. Optics here. Shot the range
here.
Can't see anyone.
Someone traveled through here.
I don't think that too.
Someone traveled through here.
No doubt.
Round two. Beginning ring countdown.
Was that close? Target spotted. Enemy over there. Blessings upon us. A replicator descends. Scanning the area.
Can't see nothing. Are you serious? We're gonna scan.
In the ejector seat.
Oh, crikey. Where are you?
I'm taking fire. How's that close? Scanning the area.
Recharging my shield.
Calling upon me.
That's why it's useless. Kill the people who made me. It's I can take it out on you. It's just fucking useless. It needs to be quicker. It needs to be another color. It just needs to be something. It's virtually useless as piss. So nobody picks them up anymore. Nobody uses them. Nobody picks them up because you can't effectively use it in battle at all. So what's the point? If your other squad mates waste the other team, then they can come and revive you. But if they're in the middle of the battle, you can't get on your feet again for fucking ages. And then you give yourself away as soon as you use the shield. So it's like, oh look, here I am. I've got a gold fucking revive shield.
Well, then exert themselves as much as possible in order to raise their body temperatures. Inside the ball, the temperature will rise rapidly, while simultaneously the carbon dioxide levels will also increase. Once the temperature inside the ball passes 115 degrees Fahrenheit or 46 degrees Celsius, it exceeds what the hornet can tolerate, but is still well under what the honeybees can handle. The combination of heat and low oxygen level will eventually kill the giant Asian hornet. Several of the honeybees will likely die before the hornet does, and this means of defense, it isn't effective against a large number of giant Asian hornets. However, it does work well against eliminating the scouting giant Asian hornets. This can potentially stop a large-scale attack from ever taking place. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below and do not forget to subscribe. Brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And if you're looking for another channel where I do also daily videos in a top 10 form.
No. Here we go. Let's try and get some kills today, shall we?
Falling for me already.
I say we land here. Things, but that man is gone.
Lovely idea. Let's find something good.
There are things on the outside too. Unfortunately.
I am taking fire, friends. Opening fire on the enemy. Reloading.
Round one. Beginning ring countdown.
The next ring's far. Come on, loot as you go.
Giving my shields a recharge.
Attention. First blood.
First blood. Gotta be someone. Glad it's not one of us.
Guys, come on.
Recharging shields.
Let's do some shopping.
Hell
of a time to go shopping.
It is, isn't it? Yes, you got. Okay, I'm gonna make do with something. I'm gonna take everything so that nobody has access to any ammunition. You got a weapon, bro?
see someone over there.
My ultimate is ready. Okay.
Enemy over there.
Hostile spotted.
I wonder what they found. One
over there.
Reloading.
I'm going to move here. We should go this way.
Mm-hmm.
Contact. 45 seconds.
Recharging my shields. Healing.
Let's explore this way.
Hostile right here.
Using grapple. Shields a recharge.
Healing.
I'm
spotted.
Recharging shields. Let's go this way. Giving my shields a recharge.
Giving my shields a recharge.
Actually.
Extended light magazine here. Level 2. Ammo up.
There is a new kill leader.
Keep eyes on the new kill leader. Here I go. I need a
hop up. Okay.
New kill leader. If they're getting cocky, they're getting sloppy.
Recharging shields. I need shields.
Okay. How far away are you? I can pick one up for you.
Enemy over there. I wonder what they found.
I need a hop up.
Mm-hmm.
Shields.
Enemy spotted.
like some people have been there.
Yep. What do you want? Oh, good grief. What do you want to do? Go over and enter into this battle, apparently. Anybody here? Right there.
Contact with hostile. Contact.
Enemy killed.
Good job.
Give me a sec. Recharging shields.
We need to kind of rotate around this a bit.
Fire. 1 minute until the ring closes and everything here. Recharging my shields.
Yeah, no shit. Oh, piss boy, you do.
Tango near me. Give my shields a recharge.
Shield battery here.
Contact.
10 seconds. The ring is fairly close.
Shields.
Taking fire. Little red tower. Throwing arc star. Throwing arc star.
Okay, thanks for that advice.
All the way through season 10, this video is thick. So I've added timestamps for you to b-hop around if you'd like to learn more about a specific season. If you enjoyed this video, remember to like and subscribe and check out some of my other videos. I think you'll like them. I'm also considering doing a Titanfall and Apex Universe video, so if you want that video, leave a comment down below. All right, let's drop hot. Apex Legends released out of nowhere on February 4th of 2019. There were only only 6 available legends to play as for free, with Caustic and Mirage available to purchase with legend tokens or Apex coins. Players began familiarizing themselves with this new hero battle royale shooter as they fought their way through King's Canyon. The game didn't actually take off right away and had a bit of a rocky start, with server issues, friends lists not working, item dupe glitches, falling through the map, and much more. A lot of the legends didn't really work the same way that they do now either. Lifeline had a directional shield when she revived, Bloodhound Scan was absolute dog shit. Gibraltar was debatably one of the worst legends, and well, not as bad as our boy Mirage. His decoy was super obvious and his ult was basically a meme. Oh, and so was the Mozambique and everyone feeding Lifeline ult accelerants. In only 6 days after launch, a relatively unknown streamer at the time, Dizzy, became the first player to reach level 100. And this was actually a pretty big deal because there were a lot of rumors that there would be secret unlocks at the max rank or that you'd be able to prestige or something, but it turned out the only secret was unlocking Wraith's Heirloom, which had a less than 1% drop rate, with the only guarantee of obtaining the kunai by opening 500 Apex packs. Heirloom shards as we know them today wouldn't even be a thing until season 4, but don't worry, we'll get there. Within a few
This might be a good place to land. Hold your breath if you have to breathe.
We're gonna make it there, or we're gonna go somewhere. Oh, what do we got? What do we got? What do you got? Oh, you got that. How'd you get that? How'd you get that from me?
Safe to touch down. We're already in the next ring.
Whee! Somebody's gonna come through that door, I can guarantee it. Guaranteed. This too. And it's almost guaranteed someone's gonna try and get us up here. Oh no, nobody's here. Are we all ready? You okay? You good? Ouch.
Here I go.
Wait a minute. Have I got 15?
Little room. About to crack open this hold.
Crack it open. The hell was that? Lots of ammo in here.
Extended energy mag here. Level 4.
What exactly am I carrying? Too much shotgun ammo. What's this big purple blob? It is of no interest to me. Way too much of this. kill him.
Barrel stabilizer here. Level 3.
Just took it.
Warning. Ring closing.
Lucky us. We are already inside the ring. Extended light mag here. Level 3.
Aren't you sweet? Thank you.
Happy to help, friend.
Cool.
Care package being delivered.
I feel good about this care package. Shall we?
Do I want this? Or do I want this?
Explore this way.
Care package over there.
Half the squads are down. There's a fool killed every minute.
Enemy.
Charging on my shields.
Grappling.
Fox 3 firing missiles.
Throwing thermite grenade.
Oh, that's nice.
Making contact with the enemy.
Contact with hostile. Making contact with them. Hostile right here.
Where's Valkyrie gone? Can't see behind it.
Here. Optics here. Close range. Backpack here. Level one. Havoc here. Mastiff shotgun here. Peacekeeper here. Repeater here. Mastiff shotgun. Longbow here. R99 here.
Inside the ring.
Where the hell can we pump?
Attention.
And dump.
Round 3, beginning ring countdown.
Lucky us, we are already inside the ring.
Come see the merchandise.
Remember who hooked you up?
I've got your nothing.
Back. Only 2 squads left. Home stretch.
Mama's got you now.
There's a clueless bogey out there. Let's scope this quadrant out here. A bandit in my sights.
Fire on him?
Hmm.
Oh shit, we're in the ring.
Great. Already inside the ring.
Delivering care package.
Incoming care package. I love this.
Not necessarily good.
One of us.
Got another bandit. Activating
zip line deployed.
Enemy there.
This dude here,
that was crazy fun. Who's next?
Has been shot 50 times.
We have our Apex champions.
What the hell?
So people didn't actually use it that often. Sniper rifles actually used heavy ammo at the time, and you could shoot the wingman a lot faster, and if you had a skull pierce on the thing, you were cracking over 100 damage headshots. And players had started mastering b-hopping and this broken game mechanic where you could skydive across the map by staring into the sky after taking a balloon. Your jets would actually push you back up into the air slightly as you approached the ground. It was clearly not intended and a bit overpowered, but it was so much fun. 4k damage badges were also a lot harder to come by because damage was only counted on enemies that weren't knocked yet. There was also a small event around Valentine's Day that rewarded the limited Live, Die, Live badge for reviving or respawning a player. With Season 1 came our cracked out boy with robo legs, Octane, the first battle pass and first event, as well as some challenges. Season 1 still took place, and players had started to better learn map rotations, and everyone started dropping hot in Artillery, Thunderdome, and my personal favorite, Skulltown. If you were a fresh noob, you'd probably aim for swamps where there was high tier loot, but not that many people, and if you were an absolute sociopath, you'd run caustic and land the bug every time. If you managed to save some high tier loot, it actually gave you the ability to use consumables like medkits and shield bats way faster, and it was pretty OP. This would later be moved to the...
Need something? I'm sure we can come to an agreement.
Gold body shield was fully replenished after finishing an enemy, which would end up just being a common thing across all body shields in Season 3. In Season 1, we also had the joy of experiencing the continuation of bugs like bad footstep and gunshot audio, inventories being all disorganized, and the lead feet slow motion bug. Oh, and cheaters were running a bit rampant on PC, with Apex banning almost 1 million accounts in the first month of the game being released. There were some shining moments though, like joining the space programs, you flew across the map, bin bug, you'd punch the top of the bin, stand on top of it, and then super jump all the way across the map. We also fully exploited Gibraltar's shield, making him carry a ton of weight in caustic traps or look like a frog bouncing around with Octane's shield. About halfway through the season, Gibraltar and caustic were given the fortified passive, which meant they took 10% less damage, and the wingman continued to get hit with nerfs to damage, headshot multipliers, and ammo count. That thing...
Conduct a search right here.
Mm-hmm. Everyone's going into this.
First kill, euphoric. Another variable until I'm ready.
enemy killed.
What happened to Bloodhound?
Used to have up to 12 shots of the purple mag. It was nuts. Bunny hopping was also pretty much removed. Thermite grenades actually started doing damage to doors. Pathfinder got those little blue crosshair indicator dots for when his grapple was ready. And sociopaths could no longer lock their teammates in a room with caustic traps. Yeah, you literally couldn't disable friendly traps for a while. The damage of the ring also got quite a few buffs because it used to just tickle you even in the endgame. Regarding the battle pass, it was a bunch of filler and recolors like the majority of Apex battle passes. But it did come with 4 legendary skins including Night Terror Wraith, Honored Prey R301, and the reactive silver and golden skins for the Havoc. We didn't expect much from the first battle pass, and we didn't get much. The Legendary Hunt event brought challenges in the Apex Elite queue with it, which, although a cool concept where the top 5 teams of a match would play against other top 5 squads of prior matches, it actually led to a lot of camping. This kind of ended up being foreshadowing for the first season of Ranked, which actually came in Season 2. With Season 2 came the release of the new legend, Watson, and a new crated energy weapon called the L-Star. It also brought a new version of King's Canyon, the first season of Ranked, new attachments, and several new events. The space cows that had been lurking outside the map decided to come hang out with all of us, and we learned that their names were Lola and Rosie. Flyers also started infiltrating the map, and everyone debated on if they should be called dragons or wyverns. Because of the new wildlife came changes to the structure of the map. Several areas had been destroyed by the space cows. The cage showed up out of nowhere.
Okay, yeah.
Prepare for battle.
Banker! Okay. Banger's gone down there. Is anyone following us in here? Yes, they are.
Recharging shields.
game.
The battle pass brought new types of cosmetics, including skydiving, floating screens, and music packs, which were basically just better filler than what we had in season one. The legendary skins from season two include the Prince of Darkness Caustic, Fugly Octane, a really fat Spitfire skin, and a cool reactive rhino looking R301 skin. Ranked brought a whole new hide and seek meta to Apex, and I'm pretty sure every Apex Predator player from season two knows every crack, hole, and ledge that you could hide on or in on King's Canyon. Luckily, we got some cool skydive trails to show off all those hours of role playing as a rat. People started boosting, dashboarding, and glitching the game to get to Predator by playing in bronze lobbies. Respawn beacons essentially became flares to get fifth partied, Watson was meta, and ammo was very scarce. Speaking of ammo, we had some new options though with disruptor rounds and hammer point rounds in season 2. The most OP gun became the alternator, I know, but it had disruptor rounds back then, and the P2020 and Mozambique actually became somewhat relevant if they had hammer points attached. The sounds of the alternator with disruptors still plague me to this day. Oh, and so does Code Leaf and Code Net. In season 2, Bloodhound got his heirloom during the Iron Crown event, which also added Octane's Gauntlet as a point of interest in King's Canyon. It was also a time when solos were in Apex Legends, and there were challenges to get top 5 finishes. As you can imagine, solos was kind of loved and hated within the community, some arguing that Apex was a team-based game and that solos had no good reason to be there, whereas others really liked the dynamic of solos and wish it stayed in the game for good, which it didn't. The final event of season 2 was Voidwalker.
Oh dear. I'm gonna jump this thing. We can jump there, but there's nothing there. How about we jump this?
I like this spot. Lovely. Remember, eyes on the prize.
I should have jumped over there. Oh dear. Peacekeeper.
Need a backpack. This barely just won't do. Massive shotgun here. No problem at all, darling. I need a backpack. Newt's belly just won't do. Heavy ammo here. The ring's our neighbor, pals, and we've got about a minute to find her.
We have 45 seconds, and the next ring's right there. Don't leave anything good behind.
I need a backpack.
I shot R99 here.
Open your shop.
Shop's open for business.
You have to see what lies beyond. Oh, energy ammo here.
Remember who hooked you up. I've got your back.
10 seconds. Ring's just ahead.
A closed door. Reckon we should head here.
My favorite kind of loot. The kind that's all mine.
Not to be pernickety dears, but the ring's on the move. We're not inside yet.
Another wee picked me up. Shields recharging.
Ooh, I feel good about this care package. Shall we?
Leggy as piss.
Backpack here. Level one. Debs, darling.
Fancy a stroll this way.
Solid copy.
Thank you. Och, nee, taw that a bo, darling.
Evo shield here. Level 2.
Contact.
Get somebody's crafting into me.
Enemy here.
Charging my shields.
Where can I get these melee shots?
You run, just how you use it.
Got recharging shields.
Wow, okay.
Fire.
Audio is fucked up.
Firing. Extended light lag here. Level 4. Who'll get on top of us? Giving him the chimney.
They're shooting at me. Right.
Double timing it.
I can't hear anything at all.
Come on, I still need you.
Oscar Mike, I'm spotted.
I'm down. Ah, God, I'm numb to here.
Smoke out. Three spotted. Double timing it.
What's wrong with this server? I can't hear anything.
That's a win for me, amigo.
Oh well. And that's probably it. That's how beautiful the games are now. The audio completely fucks out. No. Can't hear anything. So silly, isn't it? And that's it, I guess, for tonight. Oh, I could open the Apex Pack. The most exciting part of the night. Oh, at least I got some crafting materials. What have I got? Coral Reef. And a kill.
This didn't have to happen, but it did.
Oh, that's crazy. Okay. And good night. Last chance. What's the last chance? Don't miss out on buying all this stuff. Okay, well that's it. I'm going to come back maybe on 2 days front time, so Friday here. Might play some of this. Might play something else. So, good evening, y'all. And we'll see you next time. Eventually, I think in the next month, I'll actually have a real schedule happening. I'll stream possibly Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Wednesday. That's what I'm looking at now. See you Friday.